Hello, we are the SpaceX fans and welcome to the SpaceX Show, the place where you can stay up to date with everything SpaceX. On Wednesday 23rd, SpaceX successfully launched their 101st Falcon mission of the year with the launch of Starlink 661.
One, liftoff. Go Falcon, go Starlink.
The booster which launched this mission, B1073, then landed successfully for the 18th time on the drone ship, a shortfall of gravitas.
Stage one landing leg deploy. Stage one landing confirmed.
Then Thursday 24th, SpaceX successfully launched their 102nd Falcon mission of the year with the launch of NROL 167.
One, ignition.
The booster which launched this mission, B1063, then landed successfully for the 21st time on the drone ship Of Course I Still Love You. On Saturday 26, SpaceX also successfully launched their 103rd Falcon mission of the year with the launch of Starlink 10-8.
One, ignition, engines full power, and liftoff. Go Starlink, go Falcon.
The booster which launched this mission, B1069, then landed successfully for the 19th time on the drone ship Just Read the Instructions.
Landing leg deploy. Stage one landing confirmed.
Wednesday this past week, SpaceX successfully launched their 104th Falcon mission of the year with the launch of Starlink 99.
One. Ignition and liftoff Falcon 9, go SpaceX, go Starlink.
The booster which launched this mission, B1075, then landed successfully for the 14th time on the drone ship Of Course I Still Love You.
Stage 2 is in terminal guidance.
Stage 1 landing leg deploy. Stage 1 landing confirmed.
Later in the day on Wednesday, SpaceX also successfully launched their 105th Falcon mission of the year with the launch of Starlink 1013.
1, ignition and liftoff. Go Falcon, go Starlink.
The booster which launched this mission, B1078, then landed successfully for the 14th time on the drone ship, a shortfall of gravitas.
Landing leg deploy. Stage one landing confirmed.
Later today and going into next week, we can hopefully expect to see a bunch of Falcon launches. The first of these, the Starlink 677 mission, is currently scheduled for today, Sunday 3rd at 9:57 PM UTC or 4:57 PM EDT. A couple of days later and we can hopefully expect to see a Dragon mission launch. The CRS-31 mission is currently scheduled for Tuesday 5th at 2:29 AM UTC or tomorrow, Monday 4th at 9:29 PM EDT. A little later the same day and we can hopefully expect to see a Starlink mission launch. The Starlink 910 mission is currently scheduled for Tuesday 5th at 7:46 AM UTC or 2:46 AM EDT. Then, just a couple of days later, and we can hopefully expect to see yet another Starlink launch. The Starlink 669 mission is currently scheduled for Thursday 7th at 10:53 PM UTC or 5:53 PM EDT. The Crew 8 Dragon capsule returned to Earth recently and SpaceX posted some information about the mission. They said Crew 8 is undocking after spending 232 days docked to the space station, the longest mission Dragon has spent on orbit to date. Heading to Boca Chica, there was some work to remove scaffolding before Booster 13 testing. SpaceX was seen doing some orbital pad A chopstick testing. Work has been continuing for the orbital pad B flame trench. SpaceX are also working on assembling the launch mount for orbital pad B. A bunch of pipes were recently seen moved to the launch site. Work has been continuing on the orbital pad B ship quick disconnect and chopstick components. SpaceX have completed their mural addition to the parking garage at Starbase. During a gaming stream by Elon Musk, some information was shared about how Super Heavy was very close to crashing during Flight 5.
I talked about really trying to focus on booster risk reduction versus ship envelope expansion. So, kind of in chronological order on the landing burn, we had a misconfigured spin gas aboard that didn't have quite the right ramp up time for bringing up spin pressure. And we were 1 second away from that tripping and telling the rocket to abort and try to crash into the ground next to the tower.
Wow.
Instead of the tanker.
Musk responded to this and said a second is a long time to a rocket. Said another way, it was 1,000 milliseconds or around 50 control cycles away from hitting the tower. Not actually that close. There was some pretty cool information about some Raptor testing at the McGregor testing facility. It says, ever wondered if Raptor can do 5 firings back to back? Well, wonder no more. This appears to be a relight test of the Raptor engine at SpaceX in McGregor, Texas. Ship 31's heat shield tiles continue to be worked on in the high bay. Recently, the first V2 Starship, Ship 33, was rolled to Massey's test site. SpaceX then did the first cryogenic proof testing on Starship 33. Another Starship 34 section was seen moving into Mega Bay 2. Last week, SpaceX performed a static fire of the Super Heavy Booster 13 vehicle. A Booster 16 barrel section was seen moving into Mega Bay 1. As always, I have to say thanks to both Mary, otherwise known as Boca Chica Gal, and Jack Beyer for being out there filming the Starbase content. Also thanks to the NASA spaceflight team working behind the scenes on their videos, live streams, and other space content. That's it for this episode of the SpaceX Show. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, make sure to hit the like button and leave a comment down below. If you want to stay updated with SpaceX info, make sure to subscribe and press the bell icon to get notified when I upload. Thanks for watching and have a great day.